In this section, we're going to be covering export persona. An export persona can be really useful if you want to export to multiple different file types, multiple different sizes, just in a few clicks. So let's create a scenario. I have two pieces of artwork here, and I want to export both of them in two different file types. One, a JPEG, and two, a PNG, and I want that for both of them. So what we're going to do is head on over to Export Persona right at the top, click on that, and the most important thing you want to do next is create a slice. And basically, slices are portions of design that you want to export. So obviously, I have two here that I could select. So if you look down here, underneath layers, you can see there are two pieces of artwork there. And underneath it says create slice. So I can either select it from here and press create slice, or I can go over here and create a slice. So that's what I'm going to do. First of all, I'll just go over to slices so you can see them coming in. By default, your full document is shown right here, and you can toggle it on and off. If you toggle it on, this will also export. But right now, in this scenario, I only want to export these two. So let's begin. I'll select the first one and I'll right click. It says create slice. I will click on it. Now you can see artwork one is in there and it says export slices one. Okay, now I want this one. I'll right click and I'll select create slice. Now artwork two is in there. Okay, how do we tell it that we want it to export as a PNG and a JPEG? Well, if we click on the drop down arrow here on the first one, you can see here it says JPEG. Well, from here you can decide what you want. You can cycle through all of these and I will click on JPEG for the first one. And underneath here it's saying it's 1x. That means it's going to export at the size it is right now. If you wanted to export it at double size as well, you could click on that and then you've got a 2x. But that's not the scenario right now, so I'm going to click off of that. Okay, great. I want to add a PNG now. Well, you click on this little plus icon here. Once you click it, you can go ahead and choose a different file format. I'll choose PNG. So now under artwork one, we have a JPEG and a PNG. So I'm happy with that. So you could go over to the next one and repeat that process, but that seems a bit long to me. So let's take a shortcut. So with artwork one selected, let's go up here and it says copy export setup to clipboard. I'll select that. And you see this little icon has appeared. It says replace export. So now I'm going to go down to artwork two, this one here, and I'll open it up so you can see what's inside, only a JPEG. And I'll go over to replace export setup from clipboard. When I press it, now it says JPEG and it's got a PNG. So from this point, all I have to do is press export. So I'll go ahead and do that now. And I'll choose where I want it. I'll just choose the desktop and I'll click export. So if I just switch to my desktop, I'll show you what it exported. Here we go. We've got one PNG of artwork one. We've got one JPEG. So we've got the two there. And then we've got artwork two and artwork two again, a JPEG and PNG. So it worked that quickly. So let's just open this one up. So that's my JPEG. And let me open up the PNG. And you can see that's worked because the background is grayed out because that's transparent. So it works very, very well. Export persona also works really well when working with artboards very quickly. So we have two artboards in front of us and they're both named artwork one, artwork two. So at this point, I could just go over to export persona. And instead of selecting them individually like this, I could just click and drag marquee tool over both of them. Now they're both selected. I can either right click and click on create slice, or I can go over to layers and down here, press on create slice. Once I've done that, I go over to my slices tab and you can see I have two slices there. And from this point, I could just go through and tell it which file format I would like and then press export. And the same thing happens as the previous example I showed you. And that marks the end of the tutorial. If you've made it this far, congratulations, that was a long one. If you've just skipped right to the end from the start, what are you doing? Get back in there, look at those chapters. Anyway, if you did like this video, leave a comment below, subscribe if you haven't already. If you're wanting more detailed and in-depth tutorials, I've already made some, so you can go and check them out. And also I want to say a big, big thank you to all of my subscribers for all the love you've shown me through the years. You've helped to make my channel what it is today, so thank you. And I will see you all on future videos. Ciao for now.